Hello students, today we are going to take the information about the new lesson, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. Now when we are talking about the natural vegetation, is nothing but the plant communities. We all know the different types of plants around us, and the different plants we can characterize on the basis of their heights, types of leaves, and about that we are going to take the detailed information in this lesson. And I know that it is not at all a new topic for all of us. So natural vegetation and wildlife, then question will come in your mind, then what we are going to learn new in this lesson. So in this lesson we are going to take the information about the natural vegetation and wildlife, not only in India but also the world, the different countries in the world, what are the different types of forest normally we can observe in that countries, what are the characteristics, what kind of a wildlife we can observe there. About that detailed information we are going to take. So let me clear that we are making the two videos of the same lesson. Okay, so in first lesson, first part, we are going to take the detailed information about the types of forest. Okay, there are six types of forest. About that we are going to take the detailed information. And in the part two of the video, we are going to take the information about the grassland, the types of grassland in different parts of the world, as well as the wildlife. About the wildlife and grassland, we are going to take the detailed information in our second video. So let us take the detailed information about the natural vegetation and wildlife. Yes, natural vegetation and wildlife. Natural vegetation means the community of plants which can grow naturally on the earth without any human disturbance. Now, the vegetation which can grow naturally on the earth without any disturbances of human being. There is no human activities such as farming, mining, or any industrial or economic or urban development. That is called as a natural vegetation without disturbances of human being. Now we are going to take the information about the three categories of natural vegetation. In the three categories of natural vegetation, that is forest, grassland and shrubs, we are going to take the detailed information about the types of forest, grassland and shrubs in this lesson. Now what are the forest? Forest is nothing but to refer to as wood or the woods. Is an area with the high density of trees. Forest is nothing new for you. There is nothing new for you. So the area which covered the maximum number of trees, we can refer to it as a forest. To maintain the ecological balance, forest plays a very, very important role, as many of the herbivorous animals were also depend on the forest. 30% total land area is covered with the forest. And as we know about the government of the country, that 30% forest is mandatory for every country. Now we are going to take the first information about the first category of the forest, that is called as a tropical deciduous forest, tropical evergreen forest, temperate deciduous forest, temperate evergreen forest, coniferous forest, and Mediterranean vegetation or the forest. Now when we are talking about the tropical and temperate, what is the difference between the tropical and temperate? The area or the forest which can near the equator in tropical area is called as a tropical forest. And the forest which we found in the temperate zone were known as a temperate forest. Let us take the detailed information about the tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest are also called as a tropical rainforest. From these two names only you will understand. Evergreen means this forest will never face any dry season. They remain green throughout the year. And it requires the heavy rainfall. The specialty of this forest is the thick forest. And that's why there is no particular dry season. The trees do not shed their leaves altogether. That is the reason it is called as a evergreen. Okay, the examples are rosewood, ebony, mahogany are the common examples of tropical evergreen forest. Another type of forest is known as a tropical deciduous forest. This is very important that maximum part of our country, that is India, is covered with the tropical deciduous forest. The specialty of this forest is that this forest sheds their leaves in the specific month of the year. This forest sheds their leaves in the specific month of the year. And due to the sheddings of the leaf, it is called as a deciduous forest. The common examples are sal, teak, neem, and shisham. These are the common example of deciduous forest. The hardwood trees are extremely useful for making furniture, transport, and constructional materials. Tigers, lions, elephants, langurs, and monkeys are the common animals of this region. Now, this is all information about the tropical deciduous forest. Next is the temperate evergreen forest. As I shared with you that, what is this temperate? The forest which we observe in the temperate zone is known as a temperate evergreen forest. The temperate evergreen forests are located in the mid-latitudinal coastal regions. This is especially the temperate zone. And the examples are the Southeast USA, South China, and Southeast Brazil. They comprise both hard and softwood trees like oak, pine. These are the examples of the temperate evergreen forest. The specialty is that they comprise both hard and softwood trees. Another important information now, temperate deciduous. About deciduous forest, I told you one thing which is very common, that this forest can shed their leaves in the specific month of the year. As we go towards the higher latitudes, there are more temperate deciduous forests. These are found in the northeastern part of the USA, China, New Zealand, Chile, and also found in the coastal regions of Western Europe. They shed their leaves in the dry season. The common trees are oak, ash, beech, etc. And the animals which we observe there are the deer, foxes, wolves are the common animals which we found in the temperate deciduous forest. Now, another type of forest which we are going to see in detail, that is the Mediterranean forest. The west and the southwest margins of the continents are different. They have the Mediterranean vegetation. This forest is around the Mediterranean Sea in Europe. The continents like Africa and Asia, in this we observe this Mediterranean vegetation. It is also found in outside of the actual Mediterranean region, especially in the California of USA, Southwest Africa, South America, and Southwest Australia. This region marked for hot dry summers, and the citrus fruits like oranges, figs, olives, grapes are commonly cultivated over here. Due to the extreme climatic condition, there isn't much wildlife. Last type of forest, that is coniferous forest. Coniferous forests are also called as taiga. This is very important information that coniferous forest is also called as a taiga. For 1 mark, such kind of a questions were frequently asked that which type of forest is called as a coniferous forest. This forest also seen in the higher altitudes. Coniferous are tall, softwood, evergreen trees. These woods, as it's soft, so useful for making the matchboxes, for manufacturing of paper, as it's useful for making pulp. As it's soft, so it is very useful for making pulp. So the matchbox sticks, The manufacturing of paper and newsprint we can make with the help of coniferous forest. The chair fox, mink, polar bear are the common animals which we found in the coniferous forest. So this is all about the different types of forest. Thank you.